Namaskar friends, welcome to my CTech World channel. Today I am talking about if you already flashed custom ROM in your phone and want to back to official ROM. This is custom ROM installed in my Motorola phone. This is Pixel Experience, which is very smooth, and Android One ROM which is running on 8.1 Oreo. Please listen carefully what I am saying. Before you go to official ROM from custom ROM, you must take backup of EFS from TWRP recovery which you already installed in your phone. Please see carefully and you save it to your computer. If you forget it with a mistake, it would be a big mistake, because so many complaints is coming from XDA developer page that I lost my IMEI, my VoLTE has gone, 4G is not working properly. So this is the safest process to backup and restore if you need in near future. If you don't have enough knowledge about flashing routing, don't do that and kindly wait to official update release. If you have confidence you can do that, you can do it. But you should not do with hurry, because this is a system. If you want a root, you know the root means jailbreaking, and you have the power in your hand to do anything with your phones, to change boot animation, boot logo, custom UI, enable video calling, increase or decrease your processor speed, everything. But this is very risky. Today I am saying about how to back from custom ROM to official ROM without error. If you like this video, please like and share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon, because it can motivate my work with love and inspire me to do these types of hard work. And also, after you press the bell icon and subscribe, you will get the notification when any new video I uploaded in near future. Now my phone is custom recovery and I am going to flash official recovery. For this I am going to on my phone to bootloader by restart. See, now bootloader is on, and please see that it is written here bootloader is unlocked. I am now flashing and locking OEM. OEM means original equipment manufacturer. Now you got it. And now seeing this flashing unlocked also. Please behold the computer. At first I download the latest security patched ROM from the server. So this links I already uploaded in this XDA developer page. No problem, you don't have any signed Motorola ROM, no problem, but you should have a latest security patched ROM in your hand. So download it and unzip it, and before that you stop for some times your antivirus security from your computer. And when you unzip this ROM file, please copy to minimal ADV root folder. Okay, so I am copying these files to my minimal ADV root folder. And I am talking about your stop your antivirus. Why? Because so many antivirus is freezing some files of the ROMs, which can permanently or temporarily brick your phone. So don't take any risk. So guys, please watch beginning to end with patience how I back to custom ROM to official ROM. Now I am flashing TWRB recovery to official recovery. Sometimes you facing some problems for relocking the OEM. If you earlier got any OTA update, after relock you should flash by current patched ROM only. Don't forget it. Now it come to stock recovery. My phone to bootloader. This is bootloader is on by volume down and power key. Now I am typing this command I already given in the XDA page. For flashing, you can copy and paste together or one by one in this minimal ADV and enter. Now it is going on. It can take some time, so keep patience. If you have enough signal or you don't have the signal error, you can jump two step, fast boot erase modem 1 and fast boot erase modem 2. It can be helpful if you don't have any EFS backup. So now flashing is done on my computer. So phone is rebooting. Please see that. If my signal is error, yes, my signal is error because I did not jump any command. Because so many people asking about me, my EMI is zero, what can I do? So your EFS backup, how to use it, please see that. How can I solve this? Please see. Now I am flashing TWRP from my computer. So reboot your phone to bootloader. Now recovery has been flashed. I created EFS backup earlier and safely stored in my computer. Now we should restore this EFS backup by the TWRP recovery. Now copy and paste TWRP EFS file and replace the TWRP folder in the internal storage of the phone and restore it and reboot the system like this, and please see that the signal has backed. Now we should type relock commands and relock the phone. Please see that the phone has relocked successfully. Please see. So please like the video. If you love the video, and comment if you have any question. Namaskar. Jai Hind.